the ancient Gaelic peoples, when they came to Ireland, they noticed that there had been people living here long before them. They noticed the great archaeological remains in the Boyne Valley, and they associated, therefore, their deities, their symbols and their mysticism with this particular place. And it's from that that the Boyne gets its name, because Vind, the original form of the name of Fionn, Vind actually means wisdom. So that Fionn, of course, is the great prophet of wisdom.
According to tradition, Fionn received a special gift when he sucked his thumb, which he'd burned by touching the salmon of knowledge. The salmon had been caught on the River Boyne, and the actual location of the pool where the salmon was caught is just downstream from Newgrange. The text of the boyhood deeds of Fionn states, "The lad then ate the salmon. That is what gave the knowledge to Fionn, and that which was unknown to him would be revealed to him."
The 3rd and 4th centuries of this era was in the possession of the Leinstermen. But the Leinstermen were driven out of the Boyne Valley by the Email or O'Neills, and they took over this area. The Leinstermen were driven back to the borders of County Offaly and Kildare, so that they tried to get back the Boyne Valley, and there was continuous warfare for about 100 years between them. I think Fionn became a symbol then for the Leinstermen, a symbol of their ambitions to regain control of the Boyne Valley. And he only became a military symbol due to this contest between the Email and the Leinstermen. But originally, you see, he was really a personification of wisdom. Therefore, he would have much to do with the cult of seers, of poets and other men of knowledge, who tried to gain knowledge by, for example, lying on the graves of the dead, as they did in ancient Ireland. Therefore, we have so many stories about Fionn going underground and, like, into Newgrange, Brunaboyne, and such places where he would contact the spirit world, the world of the gods, if you like, in ancient times, and they would give knowledge. Richness of lore in the Fhiannaíocht. It's amazing in a way that scholars have tended to ignore the Fhiannaíocht as a full entity up to now. And the traditional Irish people were more interested in Fionn MacCumhaill possibly than anybody else. So that Fionn was very much a hero of the ordinary people.